fellas, what's ups? I know it's been a minute that I sat down and I filmed a YouTube like makeup tutorial. I know I'm very sorry. I do want to upload more makeup tutorials because I know you guys love them. I promise I will maybe like, you know, new year, new me, hopefully. Today we are going to do a very like, I want a warm, you know, top, like orange top. I want to do something very warm. I've been wanting to do this for a while, but because I took like 2 weeks break. For my YouTube fam who don't know, I took like a 2 weeks break, complete 2 weeks, no makeup, no filming, nothing, and that was like something I really really needed at the end of the year to just like start new from like next year. So anyway, I wore something like, you know, really warm, and I want to do something very warm, more like that fall vibe, like, you know, warm eyes, bold lip. Fall is gone, winter is here, but I really want to do that look, and we're going to use a bunch of new makeup. I have a lot of new makeup which I got in PR, some things I bought, so we're going to mix everything and like try it today. So there are products I've tried once or twice but never tried in front of camera, and you know, we have K-beauty blushes, we have Nikki's palette which I bought, Beauty Bay Nikki palette, I've used that once, etc. So anyways, too much talking, let's start with the video. So let's start off with primer, and for primer we have Cal Los Angeles primer. This is their new Insta Beam Illuminating Primer Oil. Now, I usually don't use oils, but when I saw the ingredient list, it has squalene. And I mean, squalene is one of the very non-comedogenic oils. So, you know, even dry skin, oily skin, anybody can use it. And they have shimmer particles, but I'm going to be mindful of where I'm going to put it. I'm probably just putting, like, you know, on the high points of my face, because I don't want my makeup to break, especially right here. It's the first time I'm trying this product, so let's hope it's good. You know what, let's just apply it everywhere. My skin is kind of dehydrated anyway, so squalene is going to help. So because it's an oil, I'm just going to let it sit for 30 seconds before I go in with any other product. So it has very very tiny shimmery particles. Like, once the oil is spread, you cannot see it, and you cannot even see it in the bottle, but once you take the little drop on your hand, and then you can really see it. I mean, my face doesn't look oily, the oil just got absorbed right in. That's something I really like. I don't like something staying on my skin because that might ruin the makeup. It just got absorbed very quickly. It just gave me a little bit of shine. So next, for foundation, we are using the MAC Studio Fix. It's not a new foundation, but I've never tried this on camera, and I don't have any other new foundation other than this, and the shade NC40. This is a tad bit yellow on me, so I'm just going to mix the Maybelline Fit Me in 310. Don't think that it's too light, it does oxidize and it just comes down to my color. So we even have new brushes. I opened one package with like one of the brushes in my hand, and this is the other one. So I'm just using their buffing brush. I really like this brush. I have the old, like, you know, I had already like been using this brush since years, just a different packaging, and they sent me this rose gold one. It's so pretty. Both of these are like the same brushes. This is orange and this is a little more prettier one. So I'm just, I did apply a lot. I should not have, but down to my neck. See, I did tell you that it comes down to my skin tone, right? So up close, the foundation went on well. Like, I did use the foundation before, so I know how it works. So the primer didn't break it apart or anything. It just added a little luminous effect, right amount, not too much, not too less. So far I think it is doing a pretty good job. Nothing like, you know, went weird or balled up or is patchy. I don't have a new concealer, so I'm just going to add an old one. So for sponge, I'm using this new sponge. This is the marshmallow sponge from a brand called Rumair Cosmetics. I've used this sponge once, like yesterday when I was doing my makeup, and I really liked it. It's a very soft sponge. Yesterday I did have a good base with this. Let's see how today goes. I'm a whole brand new base bus. Bitch on bus. So for powder, I have K-beauty HD loose setting powder in the shade Almond. So previously I had the shade Olive, and it was way too, you know, deep for my skin tone, especially under the eyes. So I got this shade Almond, and this is kind of like perfect. It's not like too dark or it's not too light, and it just kind of like sets everything in place. So I'm going in with the same you know, K-beauty powder, but the shade is different, Almond, and I'm going to just set my under eye. Shade just kind of neutralizes everything. That's the reason I usually like translucent powder, because it doesn't change my under eye concealer color. This changes it into literally my entire face looks same now. I like my under eyes to be a little bright. I feel like it just gives my face a lot of dimension once I add bronzer as well. But to each their own. Some people don't like to highlight a lot. Even if I add translucent powder now, it won't make much difference, because I anyways set the concealer and it's just going to make it very heavy. Yeah, it already made it so powdery. I don't know why my nose looks so weird. My skin has been on a roller coaster ride recently, so I'm just going to not bother about it so much. Next, for bronzer, I'm just using the Hoola bronzer. This is Benefit Hoola bronzer. So what are your plans for New Year, you guys? I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know where to go, because obviously everywhere would be crowded and I don't want to go to a crowded place, and I don't even have friends at this point to go out. Really, 1-2 friends I have, and probably we'll do house party. That's the only thing left to do now. So next, for blush, we have new blushes from K Beauty. So there are 4 shades. One is two are very pinky brushes and 2 are coral brushes. So I'm going to go with something which is more warm. I think I'm going to go in with shade Coral Charm. So these are the 4 shades. It starts from Mild Berry, Deep Plum, Coral Charm and Sugar Candy. So I've not even tried or touched any of these blushes. So okay, the pigment is not bad. This is the shade Coral Dream. Take the buffing brush from Real Techniques. Again, this is the cleaner one, so I can use this for powder as well. I'm just going to... I do have a lot of product on it. So I'm just... That is a pigmented blush. Okay, that's beautiful. That's a pure matte blush. It's amazing, because I hate shine my blushes, because it takes you apply blush on your cheeks, and I have a lot of texture on my cheeks because of my acne, and I don't like a shimmer blush for that reason, because it exaggerates my texture. And this is beautiful, you guys. I mean, it's really difficult to find a good affordable matte blush in Nykaa or India, other than Makeup Revolution and I think Palladio. NYX one is there, but NYX one is not as pigmented as I like it. High-end blushes are really nice. The Lenfo one is also really nice, but this one is one of those very few matte blushes. Usually the Fit Me one is there. It's a little shimmery, although it's nice. It is a little shimmery. Then we have Milani one is also a shimmery blush. So this is a really good matte blush. You can see it instantly added a lot of color to my face, and I really like that. All right, that was a good product. I don't feel heavy also. That is the amazing thing. I don't feel like I have blush on. Can't really see where it starts and ends. That means it's beautifully blended, and I didn't do a lot of effort. I just tapped on, and that went on very beautifully. So yay, if you're looking for a really good matte blush. Next, let's move on to eyes. And for eyes, I'm going to start off with the NYX. Oh no, we have to apply highlighter. And actually, I don't have a new highlighter, so I'm just going to apply an old one. You guys, timing. The minute I said I don't have highlighter, my bell rang and Nykaa sent me a lot of Lime Crime stuff. So I've not tried Lime Crime yet. So this will be the first time. So they have a highlighter palette. So I'll just use that highlighter probably. But the shades are quite deep. I mean, I don't think they look good on my skin tone so much, because they're quite gold, and this is deep. People who are 2-3 shades deeper than me can use it more well. Going in with the shade which one is this? This is Warm Gold, I suppose. I'm just going to take Warm Gold, and let's first hit here. It's a tad bit deeper. I mean, I can work with it. If I go with a deeper foundation, it might look nice, but it's not ideally the highlighter shade I would go. So there's actually one more highlighter which I did not try. This is the Bobbi Brown. What is this? Did it come on camera? Literally the whole brick fell off. My whole highlighter hit on the high points of my face. See, that is the color I really like. Like you can see, this is like a lighter shade. Now I'm going to blend it out, of course, but this is like a lot warmer than what I like. So I just apply it, then I rub it off, then I blend it because I don't want any extra product on my face. When I don't shave, my makeup goes on so weirdly. I mean, the hair just clings everything together. I think we have a good base except for the highlighter. Highlighter I don't like. Rest of the products I tried till now are good enough. So now let's go in with brows. And for brows, I'm using this NYX Micro Brow Pencil. This is the shade Espresso. I'm just combing my hearts, applying this. I don't know why I'm seeing this on Swadakuta Tommy. Very nice. That is the first time I heard it was like, yeah, fine. I mean, what it is. I think all his songs are like that. The first time you hear and listen to them, they are like, okay, fine, Yash Raj. And then later, when everybody starts doing it, it's like, oh, okay, it kind of rhymes. I mean, it does make like sense. Like, it is kind of funny. Alright, for eyes, we are going in with the Niki Tutorials Eyeshadow Palette, and we're going to create a very nice, warm, smoky eye using like this top bright, this color, and this color, and this color, hopefully. So I want to go in with something which is orange, but it is not there in this palette, except this. This is more like mustardy orange, not really like orange like how I want it to be. So I'm hoping if I mix this and this together, I get a proper orange. Let's try and see. I'll just first take it on my hand and see. Oh yeah, I think that works. Going to place that and blend it out. I guess that is working. So I'm not going to take any more red because I know that'll end up looking more red if I do. I'm just going to take more and more of Redemption and blend that thing out so that it looks a little more orange like I want it to look. It is a little red than I want it to be. I have these new eyeshadow palettes from it's a pigment from a brand called Rhythm Cosmetics. Now I've used this like a liner, and which is amazing. If you follow me on Instagram, I raved about them on my stories, but I've not really used it like an eyeshadow. I just like tried to blend it on my hand and it was very light. So I'm just going to try to use it. I mean, it is a lot. I'm just going to dust it off. It's very dusty because it's like a pure just pigment. Oh yeah. That is a lot better. That is how I wanted it to be. Oh, that went too much. So I think you can kind of build these up. I mean, they are a little powdery. I'm not going to. Oh my god, it is too much. I have not anticipated that. So they do blend out. Orange I wanted to be, it became kind of a little yellow, which I am not liking. I'm going to try to diffuse that with a basic truth. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. First, I'm going to take red and Redemption because I want it to be same. Like if I directly go in with the pigment on the left side, it's not going to look the same. So first I'm just going to take. So I'm noticing like the minute you place it, you'll feel like, whoa, it just like got stuck in one place. But if you go in with the brush and blend it further, they do blend off quite well. Yeah, I like it. I really like it. Imagine these are just rupees. This is this pigment. You can mix it with water and use. Basically, I used my Fix Plus. I wet it and I did like a liner and it went on so well. It's not patchy at all. These are just like rupees 159 and you get 4 for 599 or something. I was so surprised when I knew the price, but I really like. I mean, these are multifunctional. You can use it like an eyeshadow, as a liner. The way it is a little like patchy as an eyeshadow. Like, you know, there are a few places I can see it, there are a few places it's not evenly distributed. It could be the way in the application, but as a liner, it did go on very well the other day. Next, I'm going to take this deep brown shade called Ripe from the Line Crime Venus XL 2 palette. So this is like a very warm brown, and I'm just going to add that in the outer corner. Just going to add a little bit of depth in the outer edge and to my eye. It looks so pretty. So I feel like, you know, in this palette, like, I really wish there was like a proper black. That would be like so cool. It would be like a complete palette, because I always tend to go for black or white for something or the other. It's just very useful when it is in a palette, but this doesn't have that. Now I'm just going to cut my crease. I'm like not going to do like a cut crease, just a little bit of concealer, a very random way, because I want it to be smoky effect, like not really cut creasy type of feel. I mean, I'm going to basically blend it in very well after I apply the shade which I made on the lid. Going in back with that shade called Ripe, and I'm going to just blend the edges and soften it out. So next, I'm just going in with this shade called Basic whatever. I want to keep this eye very matte, by the way, if I haven't told already. So I just want the inner corner, like basically the lid also, to be very matte. I don't know, I just feel that matte vibe on the eyes today. And I'm just going to samely pack that color on the lid. It's not too white, so basically it can, you know, matches my skin tone. If it's too white, it might not look so well, and if it's like matte white and too white. So this is like a perfect balance for the look I want to go. And I'm just going to pack it on. I'm going to go in with a tiny brush. I'm going to take this shade called Mila. I'm going to go on the edges and kind of blend the two together a little bit, to blend the edges out a little bit as well. So pretty, right? I'm going to take an angled brush. I'm going to go in with this shade Ripe again, which I used in the outer edges. I'm going to apply it on the lower lash line. I'm going in with the tinier brush. I'm taking the pigment of that pod. I'm just going to blend the edges. Next, I'm going in with this Wet n Wild nude eyeliner, and I'm just going to add that in my waterline to open up my eye. So for inner corner and my brow bone, I do want to add like a highlighter shade. So I'm going in with the Bobbi Brown one, which I used on my face. I'm just going to add it right here, very tiny amount, not too much. So I'm not going to add any liner, I just like the way it is. I'm just going to take this shade, this is the shade called Classical, and I'm just going to like make a very thin line above my lash line, just so that there's no gap seen, like when I apply a lash. I'm just going to kind of wing it out a little bit, that much, it's that thin, just that, so that the lash band is not like, you know, visible, like basically the white part is not visible. So next, for lashes, I have new lashes from a brand called Gourmet Cosmetics, if you can see the name. These are the lashes in the style Vanessa. So these are how they look. I'm just going to pop these on and be right back. Alright, lashes are on. I didn't use this style Vanessa because, you know, they are more like the lashes which are flared in the center, and I did a eye which is more like elongated. So this would look good when I do a halo eye and the attention is supposed to be in center and I want like more rounded eye attention. I can use those lashes now then. But for now, I just use these lashes. These are that red cherry lashes. This is the style BM76. They're just like very natural, not natural, but you know, kind of natural and more like fluttered, flared lashes. So for lips I'm thinking I'll go with this lipstick. So this is from Lime Crime. This is the lipstick in the shade Wicked. Yeah guys, that is it. That is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I love how it looks, and that's it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel. All the products I use will be in the description box, and do ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post a video. I promise I will post more tutorials. And yeah, that's it for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one.